Warriors! So I'm not sure if that intro worked properly. You got to see my beautiful face before the intro. But my name is Coach JV. I'm excited to be with you today. And this video, I'm going to start going back down the rabbit hole, Warriors. This is what started our whole channel. I'm going to try to create the balance within my mind to not take it too far one way or the other, because as a human being, I'm working to create balance. That's the key. So yes, this type of stuff should scare you to take action, not scare you into regression. My name is Coach JV. I am the top health, mindset, and crypto coach in the world. Remember, what you believe in your heart, you think in your mind, will eventually become your words and become your reality. If you can see it in your mind, eventually you can hold it right here in your hands. What you repeatedly do gets ingrained in your subconscious mind. What gets ingrained in your subconscious mind becomes an unconscious activity. Now, you guys know I'm obsessed with the World Economic Forum, and thank you for the feedback. I'm going to keep myself on the video here. So you're going to see me going back and forth, moving the microphones around. As I shared with you guys, all you need is a microphone and a computer to get started to share your special message. So don't wait for tomorrow. Don't wait for the next month. Don't wait for 12 months. Activate now. Your message is very special. Remember, if you go down our YouTube feed here, 10 people used to watch our videos. 10 people. We just consistently worked at something over and over again, just like the Grand Canyon. If you're from another country, we have a thing called the Grand Canyon in Arizona. It's a massive, beautiful canyon. You know how it was developed? As the water went over the rocks over and over and over and over again. Whatever you do consistently will show up in your physical reality. But here we go, Warriors. Okay, so you're probably asking yourself, how does this go into finances and investing? Well, this is how I do my investing, and this is how I look at my finances for the future, and this is how I'm going to use what people deem as bad for good, okay? So I plan on becoming one of the wealthiest people in the world. I'm going to continue to verbalize this, because what you say, okay, becomes, because it's out in the quantum field, it's energy. You're catching up to the things that you're saying. What your thoughts and words are very important. Okay, so I will be one of the richest people in the world, and I will bring the money back to the people. My job on this earth is, as we move into this new world, there's going to be a separation of people. And this is biblical, right? You biblical people, you understand what I'm talking about. Some people call it the rapture. You know, it comes down on a horse, and some people go up, some people come down. Spiritual hippies like me, it's a great awakening. The earth is changing. A lot of people I know are going through a lot of shit that are trying to awaken right now. And there's a group of people that just don't know what the fuck is going on. They're looking over here at the Kardashians. They're worried about the Watt videos. They're worried about Tekashi 6ix9ine with this rainbow shit going on. And then there's a group like me that's like, fuck, this is the greatest time in human history, because we get to experience this. Pessimistic people are going to get destroyed, but the optimistic people are going to have the greatest time in human history. So why? Ask yourself, why are so many people having a different experience? Because it's choice. You all get to make a choice. That's the beautiful thing about this. There is nobody stopping you. It's not Biden stopping you. It's not Putin coming after America and China coming after America and this fake battle that they're creating within our subconscious mind to make us think that all these human beings or countries are going against each other. That's all by design to keep you trapped in a system that you have to be against Russia or you have to be against China. We're all human beings having a physical experience. But what they're doing, and I'm going to show you, is they're going to take us from a human being to a human thing. So I'm going to lose some of you very quickly in this video, which is okay. But why do I talk about this stuff? And why do I study this stuff? Why do I go down these rabbit holes? Because this is where they're taking us, Warriors. The World Economic Forum. Go watch the video that we posted out there. So it's on Rumble. Go look up Coach JV. You'll find it on Rumble. We did with David. You know who it is. I did that interview with him. And I align with him with a lot of things. There's some things that, you know, it's interesting. I need to learn more and understand more to accept, right? To understand his point of view. He's just been doing this for 32 years. I'm just a baby in this. Okay. But my point is, Warriors, is I think we can all agree that we're moving into a new world. This gentleman speaks at Davos, the World Economic Forum. Do you guys realize how powerful the World Economic Forum is? They're taking us to zero carbon by 2030. They want you to rent everything and own nothing and be happy by 2030. People say, oh, there's no way they're going to do this. But here you are, buried in a 30-year mortgage. You have an 80-month loan on your car. You finance your phone. You finance everything now. So you basically have been predictably programmed in your subconscious mind to have an unconscious response to the things that you're being presented. You've been built into this, Warriors, and it's going to get a lot more interesting. So my job is to help people reconnect back to Mother Earth and connect back to the Christ consciousness as we move into this new world. That's who I am. That's what I'm here to do. And whatever you believe is that's what I believe. So we're going to watch a video from Yuval Harari. Okay, this is the 2001 60 Minutes interview. This is some crazy shit you're about to watch.
We are one of the last.
Okay, so we're going to watch this video really quickly, and I'm going to try not to narrate this first part because I want to get through a couple videos, and then we're going to go into what's coming, okay, and then how you can prepare yourself financially and mentally for this.
Last generations of Homo sapiens, within a century or two, Earth will be dominated by entities that are more different from us than we are different from chimpanzees.
Yeah.
What the hell does that mean? That freaked me out.
You know, we'll soon have the power to re-engineer our bodies and brains, whether it is with genetic engineering or by directly connecting brains to computers.
Okay, let's pause for just a moment. He said, we already have it. Elon Musk has already created a chip that goes into the brain. Now, some of this stuff can be used for good. Remember, Warriors, think about this. If somebody is paralyzed from the waist down, you could put a chip in their brain and they can walk again. That's a beautiful use of technology. Remember, it's the tool, it's the user of the tool that makes it good or bad.
Or by creating completely non-organic entities, artificial intelligence, which is not based at all on the organic body and the organic brain. And these technologies are developing at breakneck speed.
If that is true, then it creates a whole other species.
This is something which is way beyond just another species.
Yuval Noah Harari is talking about the race to develop artificial intelligence, as well as other technologies like gene editing that could one day enable parents to create smarter or more attractive children, and brain-computer interfaces that could result in human-machine hybrids.
What does that do to a society? I mean, it seems like the rich will have access, whereas others wouldn't.
One of the dangers is that we will see in the coming decades a process of greater inequality than in any previous time in history, because for the first time, it will be real biological inequality. If the new technologies are available only to the rich or only to people from a certain country, then Homo sapiens will split into different biological castes, because they really have different bodies and different abilities.
Okay, so we'll leave it at there for that interview there. Okay, so let's think about what he just said. I'm going to move this mic back and forth to give you better clarity. Okay, so there's going to be, but what in the Bible for religious people, right? And so like I accept everybody, right? So if you're religious, what does it talk about in the Bible? There'll be a separation. Spiritual people, we're saying there's a separation between the awakened and the non-awakened. People that are non-awakened is like, holy shit, things are falling apart in my life, right? Alcoholism is going through the roof, opiate abuses. We're disconnecting from Mother Earth, right? So we know, look at how much has changed 16 years ago to today. Look how much has changed since 1990 or when I graduated in 1994 in high school. Look how much your world has changed. So we can't deny that the change is coming. We went from beepers to literally being addicted to these freaking computers on our phone. So we say this change will not come, but when we had a beeper, we didn't think we'd be walking around with a phone in our pocket. Think about that for just a moment, Warriors. This change is coming. It's already here. This technology is here, Warriors, okay? So we're going to dive into this video. Now, this is the World Economic Forum. This is Davos. He's presenting at Davos. This is why I'm so obsessed with the World Economic Forum in a way of my research and investing in technologies, okay, where I can bring the money back to the people and I can keep people grounded within our Warrior Academy to keep them focused on what I believe is the right way, my belief system, not your belief system. I believe you need to stay in Christ consciousness and higher level consciousness and keep control of your physical mind as we go into this metaverse, connected to your phone, Bluetooth. There's ways you can stay connected through breathing, through meditation, through fasting, through high intensity training, and through understanding that money is a resource, okay? We made this monetary system. So if you don't understand the monetary system, you don't understand how money works, it's just energy and vibration. So you may as well be wealthy while you're here so you can make decisions for your people. Okay, so let's dive into this. This part will probably scare the shit out of you, but here we go. This is what This is the World Economic Forum. I think this was in Davos 2018, I think it was.
Now, how exactly will the future masters of the planet look like? This will be decided by the people who own the data.
Okay, I want you to catch something really quickly. This might piss some people off, but I'm here to just get you to think. I'm not here, okay? So look at the picture. Look at the picture.
Vehicles and weapons.
When he says this, look at the picture in the background. So Jesus was 2,000 years ago, right? Was so legendary. This person reached their highest level of consciousness as a human being on this earth, right? It was deemed the Son of God. That was someone who history has lasted for 2,000 years, right? We live off of those rules and that paradigm. As we shift into this new world, there may be new people trying to create new rules. And so listen to what he says. It's really important. I'm not saying this is the truth, but listen to what he says and look at the picture they have in the background.
But bodies and brains and minds.
So that to me looks like Jesus. That looks like Jesus, okay? What will the new masters of the universe look like, worse? So that the thought process is they're thinking we need a new master of the universe, trying to make us think that something outside of us, you are the master of your universe, right? I believe I follow the life of Jesus. I do the way of the mastery. I believe in God, right? But also I don't believe that anybody is outside of me stopping me.
Now, how exactly will the future masters of the planet look like? This will be decided by the people who own the data. Those who control the data control the future, not just of humanity, but the future of life itself.
Okay, so those who control the data. So wouldn't you be racing to control the data? Think about that. That's why I invest like this, warriors. So whoever controls the data is going to be able to help human beings, Homo sapiens, stay human.
Because today, data is the most important asset in the world. In ancient times, land was the most important asset. And if too much land became concentrated in too few hands, humanity split into aristocrats and commoners. Then in the modern age, in the last two centuries, machinery replaced land as the most important asset. And if too many of the machines became concentrated in too few hands, humanity split into classes, into capitalists and proletariats. Now data is replacing machinery as the most important asset.
Okay, so this is what I've been preaching for 2 years. We're moving from industrial to technical. So those who had the buildings, the gas, the oil, the land type stuff. So who dominates the land, right? Who owns the most land, which isn't even our land. We're trustees of it from God. But whoever dominated the land through a physical structure and monetary system we created became the most powerful people. The people who had industry. Now those industry people are aging and they're trying to switch us into this new paradigm. But there's a whole new group of us that are rising up into this and understanding that we're moving into data and technology. Okay. You're not going to stop it. They weren't going to stop it going from into industrial, and we're not going to stop it from going into technical. So we have a choice. We're at a crossroads. You can sit here and bitch and complain about it, or you can be about it and recreate it and bring it back to the people.
And if too much of the data becomes concentrated in too few hands, humanity will split not into classes. It will split into species, into different species. Now, why is data so important? It's important because we've reached the point when we can hack not just computers, we can hack human beings and other organisms. There is a lot of talk these days about hacking computers and email accounts and bank accounts and mobile phones, but actually we are gaining the ability to hack human beings. Now, what do you need in order to hack a human being? You need two things. You need a lot of computing power, and you need a lot of data, especially biometric data. Not data about what I buy or where I go, but data about what is happening inside my body and inside my brain.
Boom. Okay, so I'm going to leave it there. We're going to keep going down these rabbit holes. You know me. I'm going to bring these videos to you guys. But think about what he just said. They need biometric data. So what? How do we get into our phone now? How do you get into your phone? Face recognition. On TikTok, Instagram, filters, your face movements. They can put your face on someone else's face. Whereas biometric data, they're collecting biometric data. This is not a fear thing. This is nothing new under the sun. This has happened over and over again in human history. So they're collecting biometric data. And so where do I invest? I'm investing in the infrastructure, the new financial system, the new monetary system, the new supply chain system. I'm looking at the leadership teams. Where did they come from? Think about that. Where crypto.com, their marketing director came from the acting sector. What's that connected to? Think about that, Warriors. So people would say, well, you're buying into the system. Warriors, we're not going to change the system. It's a freight train, a runaway freight train. You can either get on it and go for the ride of your life and bring and change the rails, or you can get run over by it. At some point, you're going to have to get on the train, or you're going to have to go out in the forest and live in a tent and live off the land. But guess what? There's going to be satellites that are going to be monitoring your brain and your vibrational waves, and it's going to be making decisions, and they'll find you. Like that's, I'm dead serious about that, Warriors. So you can either crawl into a hole and suffer in depression and complain about it, or you can fucking do something about it. You can rise up into your Christ consciousness and bring the money back to your people and live an amazing life on this earth, Warriors. So I want to dive into this a little bit deeper. So y'all, Harays, blistering warning at the Davos. This is, you got to go watch that video. I mean, he dives into it pretty deep. Okay. First, we might face upheavals in social economic levels, which we're facing right now. The rich are going to be very rich. Who got richest during the pandemic? The four top billionaires in the world, all tech. Okay. Companies are about to get obliterated, but tech companies went through the roof. The AI revolution might create unprecedented inequality, not just between classes, but also countries. So what's happening, China, Russia, and America are going to literally dominate all the other countries. Think about the three leaders of those countries right now. Just you, your opinion. I'm not saying anything about politics. This is all by design to bring us, and they're all connected to the World Economic Forum. They're all connected to the World Economic Forum. Okay. So why am I bringing up the World Economic Forum? This is from Business Insider. 119 billionaires, 53 heads of states, and 8.3 million in security. Why do they need 8.3 million in security at the Davos event? Let me repeat that. Why do they need 8.3 million in security at the Davos event? There's 119 billionaires there, 53 heads of state at the Davos event. So whoever controls the money, controls the information, controls the people. This is where you're heading, Warriors. This is where you're heading, okay? So I'm going to shorten this video. I'm going to kind of end it because we're going to continue these types of series. So re-envisioning corporations and how DAOs and blockchain can improve the way we organize. This is from the World Economic Forum. I mean, they're going deep into blockchain, whereas we know Ripple is part of the World Economic Forum. We know some of the biggest companies in the world are partnered with the World Economic Forum. Brad Garlinghouse is on the cryptocurrency committee for the World Economic Forum. He's rubbing elbows with all these people, Warriors. I'm not emotional about this. I'm unbiased. I'm just focused on how I can bring the money and health back to the people. Okay. Now, this is crazy from MIT. We know Gary Gensler, head professor at MIT for cryptocurrency. MIT is such an innovative. They pull a lot of leaders from MIT. How many jobs do robots really replace? I highly recommend you go read this article, Warriors. So I'm going to continue to go down this rabbit hole, okay? So I know I don't want the videos to go too long because I want to make sure that we get good content out to you guys. But I had a moment in time when we interviewed the gentleman that we interviewed this week. And I'm like, you know what? I used to go really deep down the rabbit hole. And I asked myself, why did I stop? Why did I stop? And it's no blame of anybody else or algorithm or shadow banning or all that stuff. It was because I was honestly worried about the acceptance of the content. That's gone. The fear is completely gone, Words. I've already had people call me a quack, whatever it is. It's okay. Whereas what's not okay is sitting back and watching all this change when you can do something about it. When you can raise yourself to a higher level of love, self-love, and higher consciousness, however that represents for you. Okay. Surround yourself with a great tribe and community. And this is the easiest time in the world right now to become a millionaire. It's the easiest time right now to free yourself from the just over broke system. There's literally this fork in the road where you can stay in a deep just over broke. It's going to get deeper. The control is going to get deeper. Or you can go on this Y over here and become part of the system, listen to me, and change the system. The only way you can change the system that we created, we accepted this, our grandparents, 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 moms, dads accepted this. We accepted it too. We buy cars. We use cash. We accepted this. The majority of the population accepted what the small percentage of the population created. So we can't blame anybody. The only way you can blame somebody is if you tried to change it. And you're blaming yourself, worse. Does that make sense? I'm here to flip it on you. To stop blaming the government or blaming Putin or blaming Biden or blaming, you know, the head of China. It's not, it has nothing to do with them. You're the present CEO of your life. You can make a decision right now to get your shit together, to stop watching pornography, stop playing excessive video games, play it, you know, for an hour a day, and then go drive Uber, earn some extra income. You can earn extra income, put it in a speculative asset. Learn how to invest. Read the book Think and Grow Rich, Rich Dad, Poor Dad, Richest Man in Babylon. You know, take care of your family. Freaking, you know, actually be with your kids. Be present. So whereas you can live both worlds, or you can resist one world and make your world spin. So we're going to continue to dive into this because it's just so much to talk about, Warriors. I love you guys. I appreciate you. Video's going a little bit too long, but click down below. You can join our private Warrior Academy, our 120-day challenge. What do we basically do is we help you ground you, but we also have 130 cryptocurrencies, 7 calls a week, leadership groups, support groups, everything you need to manage and stay balanced in this quantum financial system. Click the description down below. We appreciate you. Love you. As we always say, Warriors, so much fun to come.